In these next series of tutorials, we get to embark on the journey of learning After Effects. Now, learning After Effects is no small task, and we have to start from the beginning. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about the interface of After Effects. Now, in my opinion, After Effects has one of the most daunting interfaces of any Adobe program. So much so that when I first opened it, I almost instantly closed it because I had no idea what I was looking at. Now, don't be like me. I was so tempted to skip over, when I was learning After Effects, the interface tutorials. And then I found myself, every single time the person on the tutorial would tell me something, I'd have to go back and watch because I didn't know what they were talking about. The interface is so critical in understanding a program. So in this tutorial, I'm going to break the interface of After Effects down into understandable segments so we can move forward with clarity and purpose. Here we go. When you first launch After Effects, you're going to be greeted with the home screen. Now the home screen is a place where you can create either a new project or open an existing project. And if you have some existing projects, you'll see the ones you've recently been working on down here under Recent. But for now, let's just click on New Project. And now, welcome to After Effects. The layout of After Effects is built into panels, just like every other Adobe program we've worked with. Now, if you think that this looks kind of like a hybrid between Premiere and Photoshop, you'd be correct. But think about it, that's exactly what we're doing. We're using video and motion content along with design aspects, so the combination of the two programs makes some sense. Let's start up here with our menu bar. Just like every other Adobe program, the menu bar is where we will interface with the program itself. Whether we're making a new project, opening an existing project, importing different files, etc. And we'll get to each of these tabs as we go throughout the class. Below that is our toolbar. Many of these tools are grayed out because we haven't started with a new composition just yet. Right below the toolbar is our project panel, and the project panel is where we're going to be importing various assets to use within our project. Next to that is our composition panel. Our composition panel is where we're going to be viewing the project that we've been making. So when we play back, it's going to play back in our composition panel. We haven't made a new composition, and so we're left with these two buttons here to start. We'll get to those in the next tutorial. Down below, we have our timeline panel, and because we haven't made a new composition, the timeline panel is currently blank. And over here to the far right, we have a lot of tabbed content. Rather than placing this content as different panels throughout the program, they've actually tabbed it out. And it used to be that all these tabs were actually separate panels around the layout, so this has really cleaned up the After Effects layout remarkably. I like to leave this on the Effects and Presets tab because we'll be visiting these quite a bit throughout the projects. And at the very top right, we have our different layouts. And just like other Adobe programs, we can change and reorganize our layout to fit our different workspace needs. So for example, if you're on dual monitors at home, you may want to spread the After Effects workspace across your two monitors, and then save that as a new workspace. If I wanted my Effects and Presets tab here to be its own panel, you can simply click and drag that out. And then anywhere you see one of these off blue trapezoids, that's where you can place the new panel. When I release, it's relocated that panel to that new location. Now, if I wanted this to be a brand new workspace, meaning I can default to this when After Effects opens up, I can come up to Window, view all the open panels. Anything with a check mark is the panels that are currently open. But I can go to Workspace, and I can choose Save as New Workspace. So for example, you can see in the upper right, I have a workspace called Main, and that's my preferred layout. We'll be working in the default layout, however, throughout the rest of the class. So reorganize After Effects to your liking, but do so at your own risk, because I'm going to be having things in the default layout, and you may have them different. I want to reset my current workspace back to my saved layout. That puts the Effects and Presets tab back over here, and resets After Effects to its default layout. So to review, we have our toolbar up here in the top left, our project panel will import things, our composition panel, where we will view what we're animating. Our timeline panel, where our layers will exist and where all of our keyframes and animations will go. And then all of our tabbed panels over here to the far right. That's the layout of After Effects. In the next tutorial, we're going to talk about making a new composition and getting started in the timeline panel.